There's one thing no one has told you for the past 2 years. In reality, an estimated 500 to 583 billion plastic bottles are purchased every year. That number is equivalent to 1 million plastic bottles every minute. Like a plastic storm sweeping across the entire planet. Or in other words, if you line them up end to end, that many bottles could form a chain stretching all the way to the halfway point between Earth and the Sun. For the first plastic bottle, I'm going to drill a hole in the bottle cap. And if you find these reused tips helpful, don't forget to hit like to keep me motivated and subscribe so you won't miss any of the simple yet super effective DIY ideas in the next videos. Your support is the energy that keeps this channel growing. And for the can, I'm going to drill a hole right in the center of the bottom. And next, I'll drill a small hole on the side as well. Then I'll use a utility knife to cut off the bottom of the can, so I can use that section. I'll cut away the entire body of the can, leaving only the bottom piece. After cutting it out, I need to smooth the cut edge, making the surface cleaner, safer, and much easier to work with for the next steps. Next, I'll take a tire valve and use it to connect the plastic bottle cap and the can's bottom piece together. The valve fits perfectly as a sturdy joint between the two parts, helping them lock into place securely while still keeping everything neatly aligned for the build. You can easily find a tire valve in a few common places. Local bike repair shops often have spare valves and may sell them for a very low price. Motorcycle or car garages replace valves all the time, so they might even give you an old one to reuse. Here I have a few old batteries, and I'm going to check which ones are fully drained so I can recycle them. Here it is. This one is completely dead, so I'm going to use it for recycling. Now I'm going to carefully take this battery apart so I can remove the inner core inside. I'll peel away the outer casing step by step, making sure not to damage the components, because the core is the part one actually need for this recycling project. And I'm also going to make use of this metal casing. It won't go to waste either, I'll peel it off and separate the metal shell. Next, I'll cut the metal casing into small pieces and drop them into a plastic cup. This makes it easier to handle and reuse later in the project. Then I'll pour some of this toilet cleaner into the cup and let it combine with the chopped battery casing. As soon as the cleaner touches the metal pieces, it starts bubbling and fizzing right away. You can see an instant reaction, foam forming, tiny bubbles rising and the liquid becoming more active. They can form a compound similar to flux, something that helps increase the adhesion of solder and makes the solder joint stronger and more secure. Next, I'll take a piece of sandpaper and start sharpening the battery core, sanding it down until the tip becomes pointed. This will give a more precise shape, making it easier to use for the purpose of the project. First, I'll take a piece of insulated copper wire and strip off a small section of the coating at each end to expose the metal inside. Next, I'll attach one end of the wire to the bolt at the bottom of the can. I'll wrap the exposed copper tightly around the bolt's threads, making sure it has firm contact with the metal surface. If needed, I can use pliers to pinch it down so it doesn't loosen. And for the battery core, I'm going to insert it into the tire valve, but it seems a bit loose. So it doesn't fit tightly, which means I'll need to find a way to secure it better before moving on. I'll use a small piece of copper wire to pack around it, tightening the space so the core fits more securely. This extra wire will help hold it firmly in place and prevent any wobbling during use. To finish the wiring, I'll connect the other end of the wire to an alligator clip. This will make it easy to attach and detach from the power source when needed. Now I'll screw the bottle cap back onto the plastic bottle, securing it firmly in place. This locks the whole assembly together and gets the setup ready for the next step. I'll use some tape to secure the electrical wire to the side of the bottle, keeping it neatly in place so it doesn't move around during use. And that's it. I've finished building the welder. Now I'm going to leave it for one day so the battery casing inside the bottle can finish reacting completely. After one day, the battery casing has completely dissolved. The mixture is fully reacted and ready to use. When soldering, I'll turn the bottle upside down, so the mixture inside can flow down to the tip and onto the weld. This helps it act like a flux as I work. For the power source, I'll be using a standard motorcycle battery. It's a 12V lead acid battery, powerful enough to heat up the soldering tip and stable for small electronics work. This type of battery is easy to find, rechargeable, and delivers consistent current, which makes it perfect for our DIY soldering project. I've got a metal strainer here, and the joint where the handle connects has snapped off. So now I'm going to use this setup to solder the broken handle back in place, restoring it so the strainer can be used again just like before. Before soldering the strainer, I'm going to test the weld on the razor blade first. This will help me check if the welder is working properly and if the mixture flows correctly before I move on to the real repair. When I start soldering, the mixture inside works just like flux. It cleans the metal surface by breaking down rust and oxide layers so the solder can stick better. While the metal is hot, it forms protective layers so the surface doesn't oxidize again, helping the solder stay clean and secure. I'll place the piece of razor blade into the joint area, positioning it right where the brake needs to be reinforced. This will act as the contact point for the weld and help guide the solder into the gap. Next, I'll bring in the welder and start adding solder to the broken joint on the handle. As the metal heats up, I'll feed the solder into the gap, letting it melt and flow around the connection point. The flux-like mixture helps the solder spread evenly and cling tightly to both surfaces. I'll keep building up the layer until the handle is firmly bonded back to the strainer, creating a solid, reinforced weld that can hold up during use. After finishing the weld, I'll let the joint cool down completely. The solder has now locked the pieces together, giving the strainer a strong, usable handle again, almost like it was never broken in the first place. And the handle holds its shape even when pressure is applied. The metal has fused into a firm, compact bond, giving the repair a hardness similar to the original construction, strong enough to withstand regular use without loosening or cracking. In the end, this little DIY welder proved that you don't always need expensive tools to make a strong, practical repair. By combining simple materials, a plastic bottle, a can, a battery core, and a homemade flux mixture, we created a device capable of forming solid, reliable welds. It's compact, low cost, and surprisingly effective for small metal fixes.